ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरतिर्योपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् स यस्य यथा तत्र न दास्येत ऐतदात्मविदं सर्वं तत्सत्यं स आत्मा तत्त्वमसि श्वेतकेतो इति तद्धास्य विजज्ञाविति विजज्ञाविते सो लास्ट डिस्कशन टेकन बाय भाष्यकार इज द महावाक्य तत्त्वमसि इज इंटरप्रेटेड एज a vakya revealing guna or the figurative meaning of the word tvam, not that you are tat, not that you are brahman, but then you are like brahman like simho devadatta. Devadatta said you are a lion, meaning that you are like a lion, you possess some guna or quality of lion. Similarly, you are like Brahma because you possess some quality of Brahman, that is consciousness. Brahman is consciousness, you are also a spark of consciousness. So, because of that sadrushyam, similarity, or because of possessing that guna or quality, you are told tattvamasi, you are Brahman. Not in the primary sense, you are like Brahman. So why not? This vakya is interpreted in that manner. It says, na mridadivat sat ekameva dvityam satyamiti upadeshat. So this tvam is what? Before the teacher said, tvam tat asi, that you are sat or you are Brahman. Before that, what is Brahman and what is you? Hrudadivat sat ekameva advitiyam satyam. That sat that the teacher is talking about is hrudadivat, is the upadana karanam, like the clay is for the parts. And just as the parts are nothing but clay, manifestation of clay, so also this jagat is nothing but the manifestation of sat, which is ekam, advitiyam, ekam eva advitiyam, sajatiya, vijatiya, svagata, bhedrahidam, ekarasam. Satyam, abaditam. So tat that you are talking about is sat of this nature, which has to be where the tvam has to be identical to that sat. So upadesha is that sat is one without a second, non-dual. Meaning that the tvam is not different from tat. Tat is one, non-dual, ekarasam, homogeneous, with no internal differences, no external differences, no duality. In that sense, that you are tat is tvam. Or whatever is tat, sarvam khalvidam brahma, whatever is thoda va yoshaka dejara, thoda volume. So whatever is tat or sat. Therefore, looking at this teaching, the upadesha, the teaching is of this nature, therefore, tvam cannot be similar to tat, tvam is tat. नच उपचार विज्ञानात् तस्य तावदेव चरमिति सत्संपत्ति उपदिश्येत. उपचार विज्ञानात्, इफ द टीचिंग वाज यू आर लाइक ब्रह्मन, नॉट ब्रह्मन बट लाइक ब्रह्मन, देन सत्संपत्ति, एंड यू आर लाइक ए लायन, देन यू कैन नेवर बी वन विद लायन. द रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस नॉलेज दैट यू आर लाइक लायन cannot be assumed. Bahu mutto chavaj. So you are like lion cannot result into you are becoming lion. So here you are Brahman results into you are becoming Brahman. Sat sampattihi. So that knowledge which results into becoming one should be the knowledge of oneness only, not knowledge of similarity. So upachara vijnanat, by the knowledge of similarity with tat, you cannot become tat sant sat sampatti na upadishyeta. But sat sampatti, becoming one with Brahman, is this is what is taught here. And that can happen. So by knowledge of Brahman, you can become Brahman only if you are Brahman and not otherwise. The knowledge that I am similar to Brahman cannot result into my becoming Brahman. Nushatvat upachar vijnanasya. Because I am like lion is nushatvat, is mithya jnanam of I am not lion. And so if I still think that I become lion, it's only going to be nusha, mithya. So mithya knowledge cannot give rise to the satyam becoming. Or suppose it is said that this is tattvamasi, tvam tadasi, the tvam or you are being praised as tat. Suppose this is stuti param vakyam, the vakya only is meant for stuti, or extolling or praising. Tvam Indrosi, Tvam Yamaha Itivat. Like it's told, you are Indra, you are Yama. Where? You are not Indra, but you are extolled as Indra. You are not Yama, you are extolled as Yama. For whatever reason. Arthavada. Arthavada is meant to support a vidhi. So he says, Napi Stutihi. So like you are Indra, like you are Yama, this cannot be that you are like. So you are Tat, cannot be Stuti. Stuti of what? Is it that the Tvam is being praised as Tat? Or is Tat being praised as Tvam? Stuti. Says Tvam, Svete Getu, cannot be praised. Because what can we, you know, in Arthavada, what can we praise? That which is to be enjoined is praised. So here the meditation upon Tat is being enjoined, suppose, then Tat should be praised, not Tvam. So Nabhist Anupaschatvat Shveta Ketoho. So Shveta Ketu is not the object of meditation, therefore he cannot be praised. Alright, then Sat is being praised. As what? As Shveta Ketu? The Tad is being praised as Tvam? Napi Sat Shveta Ketu Tve Upadeshena Stuyate. It cannot be that Sat is being praised, that hey, Sat is Shveta Ketu. Ni Raja Dasastvamidi Stustyasyad. A Raja or king cannot be praised by saying that you are a servant. So, Brahman cannot praise by saying you are a jiva. Napi satah sarvatmanah ekadesha nirodha yuktah. And sat is sarvatma, self of all pervasive. And so it cannot be said that you are Shveta Ketu, which is a limited being. But all pervasive cannot be extolled as being limited. Like, Deshadipataheva Gramadyakshastvamiti. So king who is sovereign of the entire kingdom, can't be said that you are the king or the owner or you are the master of this village. So one who is master of the entire empire cannot be praised as you are the master of this village. Nacha anyagatihi iha. In that Tvamasi, in this Mahavakya, in this Samadhi Karanyam, Nanya Gatihi, there is no other way that this Vakya can be explained. Looking at the context, if you take this sentence independently out of context, Tattvamasi, then it can be explained in many ways, if it is taken out of context. Because we find the application, uses of the Samadhi Karanyam in many sense in different places in the scripture. In the Gauna sense, in the Stuti also, in many ways it is said. So Vashyakara takes those possible interpretations and shows how in the context in which Tattvamasi is said, those interpretations are not possible. They do not fit into the overall context. That's the whole idea. That others have taken this statement and interpreted in different ways. That can be done only if you take this statement out of context, independently. Sava esha purusho narasamayah. This purusha atma is a narasamayah. Atma, this body is the Atma, that's what the statement says. If you take that statement out of context, then the conclusion is, the Upanishad is teaching that the body is Atma. But that's not so. That statement must be taken in context of other statements made. So, then, tasmadva, etasmad, anrasamayat, anyohantaratma, pranamaya, etc. In that context, we have to see whether the The intention is to say that body is Atma, or what is the intention? To help this person slowly withdraw from the external layers of identification, ultimately to become one with or recognize his true self. So this is a teaching. Therefore, the teaching must be taken as a whole in that particular context. And when that is not done, that's what the Bhashyakara's main contribution is, that there must be consistency throughout. From upakrama to upasamvara, there must be consistency. The scholars do take a sentence and elaborate for weeks together, which is fine, that luxury they have. As long as you are not deviating from the tatparya, what is the intended meaning, what is thought to be conveyed, as long as you do not deviate from them, okay? But otherwise, what is most important is tatparya. So Vedantins always give greatest importance to tatparya. So what determines the meaning of a statement? Is it grammar? Is it tarka? Is it mimamsa? What determines the meaning of a statement? Tatparya is what determines the statement. So with what intention in mind has the person uttered the statement? That is important. And so, while interpreting a statement, you must take into account what is the meaning intended by the one who has uttered that statement. That is the most important. That's called tatparya nirnayaha. With what intention has a Shruti uttered this statement? And of course, the Mimamsakas have given us certain tools to arrive at the tatparya. And so, Vedantins respect that and use those tools. The Shadlinga, Upakrama, Upasamhara, etc. But then, what is important? Overall tatparya. So every avantara vakya has to be interpreted in the context of the mahavakya. So that which directly reveals the tatparya is called mahavakya, which leaves no doubt, tattvamasi. And every other vakya is an avantara vakya. Avantara means something that supports this. Like for the Mimamsaka, the Vidhi Vakya is a Mahavakya. And every other Vakya, directly or indirectly, supports this. Then only other Vakyas have Pramanyam, otherwise they don't have. Similarly, for the Upanishad also, the statements of Pramanyam, only if they directly or indirectly communicate the non-duality. There is Vedanya's take, as they call it. That's his take from the study of the Upanishad. The Upanishad teaching non-duality. Whether you like it or not. How can this? That is not the point here. That's what it is. The adjust your emotions accordingly, you know. How can you say this is Nitya? That's not the point. Point is, this is Brahman. Brahman is the point. Mithya is not the teaching. Brahman is teaching. That you are Brahman, and therefore your conclusion that your jiva is mithya. The jagat is Brahman, non-duality, therefore the duality is mithya. Not that we start with this duality is mithya to arrive at Brahman. We start with this is Brahman. If one non-dual self alone is real, then how do you explain the duality or the divisions is mithya? Apparent, not real. But this emotional, you know, when you become emotional about this thing, you cannot understand where the teacher, where the Bhashyakara is coming from. But anyway, so, naso na chanyagatihi iha sadatmato upadeshat arthandarbhuta sambhavati. Here, sadatmato upadeshat. Because Upadesha Sadatmatva, Sat is the Atma, that's the Upadesha. That being the Upadesha, there is no other gati, there is no other way that this statement can be interpreted. Only one interpretation is possible. So Anandagiri said, Svetaketaho anupasyatvena stuti asambhavepi. You say that Svetaketu does not deserve to be praised because he is not to be meditated upon. All right. But kartrutvat karmasu tastavagatvam. So in the Vedas, very often the Yajamana is praised or the Karta is praised that you are Indra, you are Yama. Because he is performing karma. To encourage him, to enthuse him in performing karma. So that his karma becomes more efficacious. So with greater the spirit you perform the karma, more efficacious the karma is. Therefore, I am Indra, and with that spirit you perform karma, then karma will be more efficacious. Therefore, the karta is praised. So, because Svetaketu is the karta here, of what? Of, again, meditation. You know, karta of what? Meditation. Imagine. Therefore, Svetaketu can be praised. Why not? Iti asankya karma vidhi asannidhanat. The Arthavada has a place only when it is in proximity with a vidhi. So these are all the avantara vakyas which do not have swarthe tatparyam, they have only tatparyam the vidhi. So Arthavada, Anuvada, all of these have no tatparyam themselves. And so this could have been stuti had this statement been in proximity with a statement of vidhi. Where Svetaketu is enjoined to do something, then he needs to be enthused, but there is no sannidhanam, no proximity of any vidhi. Sadatmatvamatra pratitescha. Only thing that we find is that this statement, tattvamasi, is in proximity with, in the context of sadatmatva, that sat is atma. That is non-dual means atma. Therefore, nachanya gatihi, there is no other way that this statement can be explained. All right. So, says, vikalpantaram udbhavayati. On the page 291, in the line 19, vikalpantaram udbhavayati. You say that there is no vikalpa. So, vikalpantaram, Purupakshi says, we have vikalpa, we can give you an alternate explanation. Or same thing, line 36, gatyantar abhava asiddha. So gatyantar abhava, there is no other gati. He says, who says that? Gatyantar asiddha. No, it's not right that there is no other way of explaining the statement. There is. Says nanu. So Bhashyakara says, nanu sadasmi iti buddhimatram. Iha kartavyataya chodhyate natu agnyastam sat asi iti jnapyate iti chet. Although this has already come earlier, but still this samadhi karanyam can be for upasana, meditation. Like Adityo Brahmeti Upasita, that already came. Sat Asmiti Buddhi Matram. So Tat Tatvamit Tvam Sadasi. What it means is Tvam Sadasi. You are Sat is being told. So meaning that Sat Aham Asmiti. That says, hey Svetaketu, may you have this meditation that Sat Asmi, I am Sat, I am existence, I am Brahman. Buddhi means what? Bhavana, attitude. So may you meditate upon yourself as Sat. Not that you are Sat, but meditate upon yourself as Sat or Brahman. Iti buddhi matramiha kartavyataya chodyate. This is an injunction, kartavyataya, where this meditation that I am Sat is being enjoined. It's kartavyataya. So this is vidhi. Now, even though there is no verb of vidhi here, so ling lord tavya is not there, but still under certain circumstances it can be interpreted as vidhi. As Vashyakara goes to a great length in saying that bhiksha charyam charanti putreshanayaha vitteshanayaha lokeshanayaha vyuthaya atha bhikshacharyam charanti. Charanti is merely a statement of, it describes what is that. But chareyuhu, Bhashyakara, charanti should be interpreted as bhikshacharam chareyuhu. They should take to the life of bhikshacharyam. They should, that is a vidhi, enjoining sannyasa. There Bhashyakara spends a lot of time in saying that this is vidhi. So here that he can say that even though there is no verb of vidhi, still in the context you can say that this enjoins only the vidhi kartavyataya, that Shvetaketu is enjoined to maintain this as spirit or attitude that I am Sat, I am Brahman. Natu agnyatam sadasiti jnapyate. This is not a statement of fact that Svetaketu is being told you are Brahman because he did not know. It is not agnyata jnapakam. So we say that this statement merely removes ignorance. Says no, it in fact enjoins meditation that I am Sat. Suppose that is a gatyantara. So that's another way of explaining this sentence. How about that? So says Anandagiri, Eka vijnanena sara vijnana vachana vyodat na drishti vidhiparattvam yuttaramaha. See how all the whole text is being, you know, connected here. Bhashyakara connects a whole text of the sixth chapter in the course of this discussion. So how sat sampatti or sadatmatva upadesha or upadana karanatvam advitiyatvam satyatvam. So here also then yena shrutam shrutam bhavati amatam matam avijnatam vijnatam iti udattamadesham aprakshah. So this is a pratignya, that did you ask for the knowledge of that entity by knowing which everything is as well known. So eka vijnanena sarva vijnana shruteh. Understand that when you interpret any statement, it should also be consistent with everything else that is being told. So here we are told right in the beginning that this is a knowledge of that, knowing which everything as well becomes known. Eka vijnana sarva vijnana shruteh. So vachana virodat, this interpretation that Svetaketu is being enjoined that he should meditate, I am Brahman, that interpretation will militate against, will contradict this earlier statement that by knowing Sat, everything is as well known. So I am Sat is a bhavana, not knowledge, Purupakshi says. But that bhavana will not lead you to, because you still do not know yourself as Sat. You are only meditating, you still know yourself as only jiva. And that knowledge will not lead you to the knowledge of everything. So na drishti vidhi paratvam idi uttaramaha. Therefore, this vakya cannot be drishti vidhi paratvam, cannot be the purpose, cannot be drishti vidhi or enjoyment of drishti or meditation. Or going to the line 37, atma drishtavya ityadi jnana vidhi darshanat. So elsewhere jnana vidhi is there, atma vare drishtavya shrutavya, tavya pratyaya is very clearly there. That atma must be seen, meaning must be realized, it must be heard, listened to, must be thought about, reflected upon, must be deeply meditated upon. So vidhi darshanat. So there we find that there is a vidhi or enjoyment of knowledge that you should know atma. That's what Maitri is told. Ihapi, here also the vidhi is that svapnantam me somya vijanehi iti. He somya, oh good looking one, me vijane, may you know from me svapnantam. What is the svapnantam means svapna madhyam. What is the nature of svapna or sleep? May you know from me? Idi jnana vidhi, ihapi jnana vidhi darshanat vijanehi. So that's again the vakya of vidhi. So here also we find that the teacher says to Shvetaketu that may you know the nature of svapna or sleep. May you know the nature of the self in the state of deep sleep. So ihapi vidhi darshanat. So just as in Bihadaranyaka Upanishad there is a vidhi or enjoyment of knowledge, so also here there is a vidhi, vijanihi. Jnana niyoga nishtam shastram. So this vakya tattvamasi is not jnana nishtam, jnana niyoga nishtam. Niyoga means enjoyment, command. That this does not, this is not a statement revealing the nature of thing, is a statement for niyoga or enjoyment of jnanam, where jnanam is meditation here. So jnanam can mean knowledge, or jnanam also can mean meditation. So natu agnyatam sadasidhi jnapyate natu vastu tattva nishtham ityartha. So Purupakshi says that this vakya is jnana niyoga nishtham, which is dedicated to niyoga or enjoyment of knowledge, and not vastu, not revealing the nature of vastu, it is for meditation on the vastu. Then say the tika further, niyoga nishthatve shastrasya niyoga paratvena vastuni tatparya bhavad. Vastunah advidyatvam na siddhyadidhi shankavadiyeva siddhanti ashankam ashankade. Somebody in between says, you know. So in between somebody replies that fellow. Niyoga nishtatve shastrasya. If shastra, meaning this mahavakya, is niyoga nishtam, is only devoted to niyoga or enjoyment, meaning this vakya enjoining the duty of meditation, then shastrasya niyoga paratvena, meaning that this vakya only enjoins something, some action of meditation, vastuni tatparya bhavat, then the tatparya, the purport is not to reveal the nature of the vastu, meditation upon vastu, vastunah advityatvam na siddhyati, in that case, so I am meditating that I am Brahman, not that I am Brahman. So I and Brahman are different, then only meditation can be possible. I can meditate upon something that is different from myself. I cannot be the object of meditation of myself. I cannot meditate upon the self. Because meditation is a mental act. When there is an action, then there is a karta or performer of action. So I can meditate when I am a meditator, who is meditating upon something other than myself. So meditation, like any other action, involves a karta, a doer. Who is, then there is a, he is one of the accessories, one of the karaka. So kartra is there, karma is there, karanam is there. The object of meditation, Brahma, becomes karma. And the act of meditation becomes karanam. I become the karta. Then advityatvam is not there. Advityam vastuna advityatvam na siddhyati. Then sat upon which I am meditating cannot be non-dual. If I have to meditate upon that. So look, ekameva advityam will be contradicted. Somebody says, idi shankavadi eva siddhantya. Siddhanti asanga means siddhanti would have this ashanka. But shankavadi himself says that shanka. Nanu iti Vashyakara says. Nanu asmin pakshepi ashrutam shrutam bhavati ityadi anupapannam. So understand that when it is said that everything is known by knowing one, he also said that one is advitiyam. See, by knowing one thing, everything can be known, provided that entity is advitiya, non-dual. If there is anything separate from sat, then by knowing sat, you cannot know everything. If by knowing sat, everything is well known, then sat must be non-dual. So, it says that if you say that this vakya enjoins an action of meditation, then asmin pakshevi, in this paksha also, ashrutam shrutam bhavati, what is not heard becomes heard, na upapadye anupannam, that would not be tenable, would not be logical. So asmin pakshe api, what is api? Says Anandagiri, gauna pakshevi, tulya anupatthi iti apeherta. Meaning that if you are like Brahman, that also, you are like Brahman. That knowledge also will not bring about the knowledge of everything. I am like Brahman will not be a knowledge by which everything is known. Or I am meditating upon Brahman also is not the knowledge that will bring the knowledge of all. So apehe, as was the case with the gaunam, so is the case with this vidhi. Or the other Tikakara says, vastu mahatma pratipadanam jnana vipakshe anupayogi ityartha. It is merely jnana vidhi that you meditate upon sat. Then why should they say sat is one by knowing which everything? So mahatmyam. So vastu mahatmyam. The mahatmya or glory of vastu serves no purpose. Shvetaketu was merely to enjoy the meditation upon sat. Then saying that by knowing sat everything becomes known, that mahatmya or glory does not serve any purpose, doesn't help him as far as meditation is concerned. Doesn't help him in the vidhi. Vidhi does not require the glorification of vastu. Just say that you do this, that's all. So anupayogi. So then you have to explain. If this is enjoyment of meditation, then you should explain. What is the purpose of saying that by knowing sat everything becomes known? What purpose would that vakya serve? In case of the vidhi, it would not serve any purpose. Then the Pura Pakshi says, na vastu mahatma param tadvakyam kintu tadvakyam stuti paramiti. Eka vijnana sarvijnanam is not glorification of the vastu. Only it is for stuti. So that vastu, look how great is sat. By knowing one sat, you know everything. So, stuti param, it is a stuti, and not knowing one, you know everything is, does not mean you to take it literally. It is merely stuti of Sat. Look Sat, how great Sat is, how great Brahman is, that knowing Brahman, everything becomes as well known. So glorification of Brahman does not, this is not the description of Brahman, it is glorification of Brahman. Eka vijna. So now, by knowing one, you know everything either can be a statement of truth or it can be merely just praising. So Vedantin says that by knowing one, everything becomes known is the statement of truth. Purupakshi says, no, it is merely glorification of Sat. Sat is being praised by saying that by knowing Sat, everything is well known. So, na vastu mahatmya param tad vakyam. That vakya, knowledge of one leads to knowledge of everything, is not vakya that really describes the glory of Sat. But it is merely praising Sat. Praising means what? Sat is not really like that. Tvam Indraha, Tvam Yamaha, you are Indra, you are Yama. It's very clear that you are not Indra, but you are being praised. So Sat is not such that by knowing you know everything. But then is a praise or extolling. Iti Pariharati na. So then Purvapakshi says, or Anandagiri said, Eka Vijnanena Sarvijnana Srutehe Na Virodhastiti. Says, no, that knowing one, everything can be known, that statement is not contradicted by our interpretation that this is the Vidhivakya. So Bhashyakara says, this is again the reply of the Purvapakshi, understand. An intermediate fellow say to him, this Purvapakshi replies, na sadasmi iti buddhivithehe stutyarthatvat. So that vakya, by knowing Sat, you know everything, is for stuti for what? Buddhivithehe. So stutyarthatvat. Because buddhi or this meditation is enjoined. And in support of the enjoyment is arthavada. Oh, you are meditating upon Sat. You know what is Sat? By knowing which everything becomes known. So that way the glorification not of Sat, but glorification of the meditation upon Sat. Buddhi vide. So vidhi or enjoyment of this meditation is being praised by saying that you meditate upon yourself as Sat, by knowing which everything as well becomes known. Or as Anandagiri says, na idam eka vijnanena. So now the reply of the Siddhanti. Na idam eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam drishti vidhistuti. He says, no. This statement that by knowing Sat everything becomes known is not a stuti. It is a statement of fact and not a statement of stuti or praise. Kaya karana ananyatvadi yuktibihi upapaditatvat. So understand that Shruti does not merely make a statement that by knowing Sat everything is known, not just a statement. But that statement is supported by yukti. How? What's the yukti? So, yatha ekena nutpindena saram runvem vijnatam. So just as by knowing mrut or the clay, which is the material cause, everything made of clay is well known, so also Sat is the material cause, and therefore by knowing Sat, everything is as well known. So this statement of fact, supported by reasoning, upapaditattva, it is logically also supported. Vidhi paksheche, then also आचार्य भाष्यकार नाउ ब्रिंग्स दैट स्टेटमेंट आचार्यवान पुरुषो वेद व्हाट्स द रोल ऑफ दैट स्टेटमेंट दिस नॉलेज इज टू बी गेन्ड फ्रॉम आचार्य व्हाट डज आचार्य डू असंभावनादि निराश समर्थ आचार्यवत्व उपदेशात उपदेश अनर्थक्यात If this is merely vidhi, then hey, Shvetaketu, meditate upon yourself as sat. Then go to Acharya to get this now. He already told. Now, you are sat. Then hey, Shvetaketu, to know that you must go to an Acharya. But meditate upon sat, you don't need to go to Acharya because of performance action is enough that you meditate upon sat. So because when you say that you are Brahman, lot of problems arise. Asambhavanadi, how can I be Brahman? I know that I am a jiva, I am a spark of consciousness. How can I be consciousness? So asambhavana is there, samshay bhavana is there. That statement causes lot of internal turmoil. When a person is told you are Brahman, you cannot just take it like that. How can I be Brahman? I know who I am. I know that I am a jiva. I am just a small, insignificant creature. I am a spark of consciousness. How can I be conscious? How can I be limitless? So as soon as I am through asambhavana, it is impossible. That kind of reaction arises from me. Lots of doubts will be there. Am I karta, bhokta, this, that? So that you are Brahman, that statement will bring about many difficulties within, such as Asambhavana, samshaya bhavana, therefore you need an acharya who can resolve all that. So the teacher knows that when you are told tattvamasi is going to bring these problems within you, therefore you must go to a competent teacher who can resolve all these problems and enable you to see the statement, the fact of the statement. And so asambhavana, nidirasa, samartha, Acharyavatva upadesha anarthakyat. In that case, there was no need to be told that Acharyavan Purusha Veda. You don't need an Acharya for understanding. Do this work. Just vidhi. For do it, I don't need Acharya. I'm just told to do that. That's all. Aupadeshika jnana matrana vidhi anusthana siddhehe. Vidhi anusthanam is what? Implementing what I am told. Please bring a glass of water. It's very clear. Please bring. Now I know what bringing is. I don't need an acharya to tell me that what is bringing. If I don't know what water is, I may need somebody to tell me, but this vidhi, do this. Doesn't require any further explanation. Merely statement, please cook, please bring. Please sit, please go, please come. Now that statement is very clear, doesn't require any further explanation. You don't require an acharya. Oh, what do you mean? Going means what? I never knew what going is. So that asambhavana, viparit bhavana, etc. is not there. Therefore, even when you are told to do something, it does not bring out any problems like that. Why should I do is a different problem. But then, what do you mean do? What is meant by doing? That question is not there. Therefore, aupadeshika jnana matrana vidhi anusthana siddhehe. Perform this ritual. I know what I am told, so that statement is enough for me to perform the ritual. Do this thing. That is enough for me to be able to do things. So, vidhi anusthana siddhehe. Implementing what I am told becomes possible simply by being told and no further explanation is required. Vidhi apekshitasya cha teneva akshepat. Therefore, there is no other apeksha as far as further knowledge instruction is concerned. Idu uttaramaha na iti Bhashyakara says. और से सिद्धांत दूषयति न इति न आचार्य भाष्यकार से न आचार्यवान पुरुषो वेद तस्य तावदेव चिरम् इति उपदेशात् सिज न मीनिंग दैट दिस वाक्य स्तुति परम वाक्य विधि परम द एक विज्ञान है ना सर्वविज्ञान विस्तुति दैट्स नॉट राइट वाय आचार्यवान पुरुष वेद इति स्वेद के स्टोर आचार्यवान पुरुष वेद दिस नॉलेज ऑफ आइडेंटिटी विद ब्रह्मन कैन बी गेन ओनली बाय द वन हु हैज अ कॉम्पिटेंट टीचर तस्य तावदेव चिरम एंड दिस नॉलेज ब्रिंग्स अबाउट मोर लिबरेशन दिस लिबरेटिंग नॉलेज that he has to wait only so long as his body does not drop off, then he becomes fully liberated. So, therefore, the statement must be taken in context of these other two statements also. Iti upadeshat. Tadeva vivrunati. This is called Sangraha Vakya. Bhashyakara said that in capsule form, in brief, and then Vivranati, Bhashyakara explains that Vakya himself. Says the other Tika in the line 19, Acharyavan Purusho Veda iti. So when the teacher says Acharyavan Purusho Veda, one who is Acharya or teacher, he acquires knowledge. He alone acquires knowledge also. Only the person who is Acharya, he acquires knowledge, means other does not. What does it mean? Acharya Jnana Sadhanam iti Visheshanena Uchyate. Acharyavan. Acharyavan Purusha Deva. What is Visheshanam? Acharyavan Purusha. Purusha Veda, it is Acharyavan Purusha Veda. That Purusha, the aspirant, is qualified by being one who possesses Acharya. Therefore, only when he possesses Acharya that he gains the knowledge, meaning having Acharya is required for knowledge, so Acharya is a means of knowledge. So that statement, in fact, says Acharya Jnana Sadhanam, that Acharya is a sadhanam, is a means of knowledge, is what is being communicated by statement that the one who is Acharya knows. Tad vastu paratve, why do we need Acharya? Tad vastu paratve, tasya durgnyayatvat. If that statement, tatmamasi vastu param, tad vastu param, a statement which is meant to reveal the nature of reality, then tasya durgnyayatvat, that tat or sat, is extremely subtle, and therefore durgnyayatvat, it is extremely difficult to know, comprehend. Pratyakshadi virodha pariharena, because it contradicts our experience. My experience is that I am a limited entity, and I am told that you are limitless. That is in contradiction with what my experience is. So somebody has to now resolve all that. So virodha pariharena, you require Acharya for removing all these apparent contradictions. So I feel that my experience contradicts this statement, I am Brahman. It doesn't. So not that I have to question the statement, I am Brahman, but then I have to understand what my interpretation of experience is. So then teacher will point out to me, hey, you are not experiencing that you are a limited being. You are not experiencing that world is different from you. You are not experiencing that Brahman is, you are different from Brahman. That's not your experience. That is the interpretation of your experience. That I am a limited being is interpretation of experience. That there is a limitedness somewhere, but not where you think it is. That yes, your body is limited. Your body, mind, sense complex is limited. But to say that I am limited is an interpretation arising from aviveka. It is the inability to distinguish between the two entities, where the two are lumped together into one. So this interpretation that I am limited has arisen, not because you are experiencing a limited I, but because you are lumping together the limitless I and the limited upadhi, take that to be one, and then you have come to conclusion that you are limited. No, this will be pointed out. So virodha pariharena, you concluded that you are different from the world and world is different from you. That conclusion also arises because you take yourself to be confined to this body-mind-sense complex because of identification. Therefore, whatever is outside the body is assumed by you or taken by you to be different from you. But that you are not this body-mind-sense complex, you are the consciousness. Vishvam darpana drushyamana yatulyam nijantargatam. When you look upon yourself, your consciousness, you see the whole universe is within you, not without you. Like in the dream, the whole universe of dream is within you, but not knowing, you think it is without you. So also, even the waking universe also is within you, and because of ignorance, you think it is without you. So, virodha pariharena. Acharya is the one who has to dispel, remove all these apparent contradictions which are there in the mind of the student, because then only the knowledge will settle into him. Even if he is told you are Brahman, as long as there are doubts, there are errors, there is lack of clarity, so long it will not become knowledge. Therefore, it is the job of teacher to remove avaranam, samshaya, viparyaya. अद्वितीय वस्तु प्रतिपादन तात्पर्य लिंगादि निरूपणस्य अपेक्षितत्वेन. सो यू ऑल्सो रिक्वायर समबडी टू पॉइंट आउट टू यू द लुक दिस टेक्स्ट इन फैक्ट इज डिवोटेड टू रिवीलिंग द नॉन ड्युअलिटी. अद्वितीय वस्तु प्रतिपादन तात्पर्य तात्पर्य लिंगादि. सो माय तात्पर्य लिंग उपक्रमोपसंहारो अभ्यास है अपूर्वता फलम अर्थवाद है उपपत्ति. सो दिस षड्लिंग आचार्य यू एम्प्लॉय षड्लिंग टू मेक द स्टूडेंट सी दैट द तात्पर्य द होल टेक्स्ट इज इन रिवीलिंग द नॉन ड्युअलिटी. ऑल ऑफ दिस आचार्य कैन डू ओनली एंड दैट्स द रोल ऑफ आचार्य. Apekshitatvena, this is also required to tatparya nirnaya, that's called shravanam. What is shravanam? Tatparya nirnaya. So shravanam is the vichara, the Upanishad vakya vichara, a deliberation upon the meaning of the statements of Upanishads, by which the student sees the Upanishad's teaching is in non-duality, to make him see that. तदर्थम आचार्य अपेक्षणात् युज्यते. तदर्थम आचार्य अपेक्षणात् फॉर दैट फॉर रिमूविंग द डाउट्स एटसेट्रा रिमूविंग द एरर्स फॉर शोइंग द तात्पर्य इन नॉन ड्युअलिटी ऑल ऑफ दिस यू रिक्वायर आचार्य. Then again Tikakara continues, vidhi paratvetu. If this was only a statement, vidhi para means enjoining an action of meditation. Agnihotradi vakya tulyatve. Then agnihotram juhuyat. May one perform the agnihotra karma. So that's a vidhi vakya. Then this also vakya would be similar to that. Meaning that then whatever kind of rules apply to vidhi vakya would apply here. What is the typical vidhi vakya? Agnihotram juhuyat. May one perform agnihotra karma. Like, so sadasi or sadasmi इति जानियात मे यू नो दैट आई एम सत मे मेडिटेट अग्निहोत्रादि वाक्य तुल्यत्वे अध्ययन विधि आक्षिप्त आचार्य व्यतिरेकेण पृथक आचार्य अनपेक्षणात इफ दिस वॉज मियरली अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ आस्किंग हिम टू डू समथिंग देन यू डोंट नीड अ सेपरेट आचार्य अदर देन दिस आचार्य इज ऑलरेडी देयर हु इज टेलिंग यू डू दिस अदर देन दैट यू डोंट नीड अनदर आचार्य सो अध्ययन विधि आक्षिप्त आचार्य सो स्वाध्याय अध्येतव्य है वन शुड स्टडी वन सोन ब्रांच ऑफ वेदा एंड स्टडी प्री सपोज इज ऑल्सो ए टीचर बिकॉज यू कांट स्टडी अदरवाइज सो प्री टीचर इज प्री सपोज दैट सो देन यू नीड नॉट टू से यू गो टू द टीचर द टीचर इज ऑलरेडी प्री सपोज इज टेलिंग यू स्टडी देन ही कांट आस्क यू गो टू द टीचर देयरफॉर अध्ययन विधि आक्षिप्त आचार्य व्यतिरेकेण पृथक आचार्य अनपेक्षणात् देयर इज नो एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ अनदर आचार्य अदर आचार्य हु इंस्ट्रक्ट्स यू दैट डू दिस अयुक्तम स्यात् देयरफॉर दिस वाक्य व्हाट वाक्य आचार्यवान पुरुषवेद युज्यते वुड बी प्रॉपर इफ दिस वॉज वस्तुपरम वाक्य would be not na yujyate would not be proper if this was a vidhi paravakya so how that statement fits into that you know tadeva vivrunati that alone vashyakara explains yadi hi so vashyakara said already no now says further yadi hi sadasmi iti बुद्धिमात्रं कर्तव्यतया विधीयते न तो त्वं शब्दवाच्यस्य सद्रूपत्वं एव तदा न आचार्यवान् वेद इति ज्ञानोपायोपदेशः वाच्यस्यात् यदि इफ इफ एज यू से सदस्मीति बुद्धिमात्रम कर्तव्यतया विधीयते इफ एज यू से तत्वमसी इज मियरली अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ विधि और एंजॉयिंग अपॉन श्वेतकेतु द मेडिटेशन दैट आई एम सत सदस्मी आई एम सत सो मेंटेन दैट थॉट फ्लो इफ दिस वॉज वॉट इज इंटेंडेड बाय द स्टेटमेंट देन Nadutvam Shabdavachyasya Sadrupatvam It doesn't say that you are Brahman, meditate upon Brahman. If this was the case, Tada Acharyavan Vedayati Jnanaupayopadesha Navachyasyat Then Jnanaupayopadesha, it said Acharyavan Purushaveda So Jnana, so then teacher is saying Jnanaupaya, what is the means of knowledge? Tadviddhi Pranipatena परिप्रश्नेन सेवया उपदेक्षन्ति सो सेम वाक्य एक्सप्लेन बाय लॉर्ड कृष्णा तद्विद्धि प्रणिपातेन परिप्रश्ने व्हाट इज आचार्यवान प्रणिपातेन परिप्रश्नेन सेवया विद्धि सो मेक आचार्य योर मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज बाय प्रणिपात परिप्रश्न सेवा उपदेक्षन्ति ते ज्ञान बिकॉज यू आर possessed of Acharya, only when Acharya imparts teaching to you. So merely by going to another person, it does not become your teacher. He must also take the role of Acharya and look upon you as a fit aspirant or disciple. Then only that you become Acharyavan. Simply by going to somebody, you don't become Acharyavan. So Lord Krishna, how do you become Acharyavan? Pranipatena, Pariprasnena, Sevaya. Go and surrender yourself. Place yourself at his disposal. Pranipatena. Sevaya, please him by serving him. Show dedication and sincerity. That you mean that your prostration was an external thing, but you mean that. And then Pariprasna, that you are a Jignyasu, Brahma Jignyasu. You come, you are not for anything else, but Brahma Jignyasu. Then Upadekshan, then you become Acharyavan. Then Upadekshan, Dite Jnanam, then they will impart the teaching to you. So, this would be the Jnana, that therefore Acharya becomes Jnana Upaya. So, this Upadesha Acharyavan Purusha Veda is Upadesha of becoming Acharyavatvam, Acharyavan. So, is where Acharya is told as the means of knowledge. That would not be necessary if this was a Vidhi Vakya, because then the Vakya is clear. You do this, does not raise any doubt, doesn't require any further explanation. So, Acharyavan Purusha Veda would not be necessary. This Tika here says, Bhadya Syat. So, Upadesha Vachya Syat. Or Bhadya Syat Dipathe Na Syat Ityartha. But already one Na is there, you know. So, I don't know. Bhadya Syat. Upadesha Bhadya Syat. Dipathe Na Syat Ityartha. Upadesha Na Syat. Then that Upadesha would not have been there. But then Na is there earlier also. Na Acharya Van Veda. So, I don't know. Anyway. Also, Anandika says, Acharya, Acharya Vattvam iti na upadishyate iti. So, then further Bhashyakara says, Yatha Agnihotram Juhayat Ityamadishu Artha Praptam eva Acharya Vattvam iti tadvata yatha agnihotram juhuyat. Then this vakya would be similar to this vidhi vakya, agnihotram juhuyat. May one perform the agnihotra karma, may one meditate that I am Brahman. Iti eva mahadishu. So this and similar vakyas, which are the vakyas enjoining an action. Artha praptam eva acharya vattvam. Already he is an Acharya who is telling him to do this, in, you know. And therefore, that very statement, Agnihotram Juhuyat, presupposes an Acharya. Artha Praptam presupposes. Or by implication. So that's called Arthapatti. So you could not have been told, do this, unless there was somebody who tell you. Do this, you can be told, provided there is somebody who tell you, do this. So, may one perform Agnihotra means that there is somebody who says perform Agnihotra. So that Acharya of the Veda is already presupposed. So Acharya Vattvam Edi Artha Praptam. So no other Acharya is required. This also had been a very statement that no Acharya would have been required for knowledge. Acharya Van Veda. Veda means knows. Acharya, what kind of Acharya? Who is Jnana Sadhanam. Not only sadhana or instruction. So, then niyoga sadhanam is one thing. One who instructs you to do something is one thing. One who teaches you is another thing. So, with Veda is that Acharyavan Purusho Veda. Means one who is Acharya acquires knowledge. Then Acharya is means of knowledge, not means of instruction. Had this been instruction, then all you need is the teacher for instruction, which is already there in the statement, do this. Then you don't need further the teacher of knowledge. But here, the Shruti says that go to a teacher for knowledge means this is not a statement of instruction, it is a state of knowledge revealing the nature of reality. Then further, itascha naidam vakyam drushtividhi param ishtavyam ityaha. Okay, I think we'll continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate
पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ॐ।